the creativity of the period did not come to an end with architecture, sculpture, and painting. Artists' creativity touched every sphere of life, whether it is art of clay, the terracotta figurines. We have some of the best examples in eastern India, in a site like Jagjivanpur, from Bangladesh, in sites like Paharpur, Moinamoti. We have very fine examples of ivory working, especially from Kashmir. We have few very good examples from other parts of the subcontinent. The artists must have worked in metal. We have very large number of bronze images from different parts of the country, and more particularly from eastern India. The artist worked in wood. We have few examples surviving from Bengal, and artists must have worked with all available medium, some of which are essentially ephemeral in nature. He must have worked on textile. We do not have the examples. They have not survived the ravages of time. He must have worked on two-dimensional material, painting. Apart from the manuscript painting, there must have been a very rich tradition of popular painting which has not survived. But the point that I am trying to make is the artist's creativity pervaded our entire existence. There was not one single aspect of human existence which remained untouched by the artist's creativity. In the process, a great but diverse tradition of art and architecture came up, grew up in the period between 650 and 1200.